All right, so time to talk about the various solutions out there for the intermediate shaft bearing on the 986 Boxster and the 996 911. So there are several aftermarket kits for these intermediate shaft bearings, and I thought I'd go through them all, talk about their various features, and then explain what I chose to do on my car. Before I begin, however, I should remind you of the phenomenon psychologists call confirmation bias. Basically, this means if you've already formed an opinion or if you've already made a choice, you reject any information that disagrees with that. Basically, if you've already formed an opinion, don't watch this video because you'll be angry, offended, outraged, whatever. Start leaving nasty comments and getting into some sort of debate that's been hashed over and over again a million times. If you haven't formed an opinion, however, go ahead and watch this because this is my opinion, which informed my decision. It does not have to be your decision, but the information I provide might be useful to other people. Okay, so with that, let's get started. So for the first solution, we have a kit by Pelican Parts. Basically, what they tried to do is assemble a kit that was as close to the stock factory bearing as possible, since Porsche didn't actually provide any Porsche-branded replacement. So they have a steel ball bearing that's very similar in spec to the original one. It has two rubber seals, just like the original one has. It doesn't have a direct oil feed. It doesn't add any like line to lubricate it. Also like the original one. Its cost is pretty reasonable, $185, but it only comes in a single row version. So if you have a dual row ball bearing, then you have to buy the single row ball bearing to replace it and just use spacers. Second one, cylindrical IMS solution. I don't know if this has a brand name or not, but there is one floating around. It's a cylindrical roller bearing. So bearing type cylindrical, it's not balls, they're little cylinders. Seals, no. Cylindrical bearings can't have seals because there's no way to really properly internally lubricate them. Direct oil feed, yes, it has to have a direct oil feed. It is different from some of the other direct oil feed systems, however. You have to modify the oil pump, which could possibly weaken it. So, not a great oil feed system. Cost, $450. Quite a substantial increase from the Pelican kit. And number of rows, one, because roller bearings always have just one row. All right, next, Pedro's direct oil feed. This is actually one of my favorites, probably. It has an optional steel ball bearing. The kit and this price does not include the steel ball bearing, which is kind of nice because you could potentially source your own bearing for Pedro's direct oil feed kit. The bearing doesn't come with seals because it does have a direct oil feed, and I think Pedro was really the champion of the direct oil feed. It adds in a line that pumps in clean, cooled oil onto the bearing to help lubricate it, which is the best direct oil feed system I've seen, much better than this one. And that sprays the oil directly onto the bearing to lubricate it. The cost is $800, which is expensive, but you can use it on one or two row ball bearings, and you can actually even use the existing ball bearing and just add in Pedro's direct oil feed line. Finally, way over here, Ellen Engineering. This is the only option of the four that uses a ceramic hybrid ball bearing. And that's quite nice because ceramic hybrid ball bearings are much better. They offer lower rolling resistance. They're a bit stronger. They don't require the lubrication that some of the others do. They can run with less lubrication and not damage themselves. So the ceramic hybrid's a big plus for Allen Engineering. It does not come with seals, and it does not come with direct oil feed. So it has no lubrication except for the splash oil. It is $800, and it is available in either one or two rows. Something that Allen Engineering does that I haven't seen anyone else do is they have a custom bearing where they were able to fit a double row ball bearing in the place of a single row ball bearing, which is quite clever and probably good. Okay, so those are the four common options. I don't claim that they're all the options. In fact, Allen Engineering recently came out with a planar bearing. I don't even know if it's necessarily called a bearing anymore. It replaces the ball bearing completely. They claim it's the only lifetime fix. It looks pretty fancy. It probably works pretty well. I didn't include it for a couple of reasons. It's very new and difficult to get a hold of at the moment. It's very expensive at $1,700. And, well, I'm sure Allen Engineering has been testing it for quite some time. It hasn't been out on customer cars. It hasn't driven millions of miles. We don't really know what it's like. For all these reasons, I didn't include it in the list, but it's definitely something to keep an eye on in the future. Not something really practical right now because you can't get a hold of one and because they're very expensive. Okay, so all of that is fine and dandy. Let's go through these and start talking about various problems with each of them and get into the one that I chose. So let's start with the Pelican Parts Kit. The factory setup on my car lasted really well. The bearing that came out of there looked great. So I like the idea of putting a cheap kit that matches those specs into the car. You're not gonna have any surprises. It worked all right initially, so this should work all right too. But what are the problems? Well, there are two problems. The first problem is it only comes with a single row bearing. So I have a double row bearing. I would have to replace my double row bearing with a single row and spacers, which would be weaker than the original design. Not really keen on that. The other main problem with this is that, at least at the moment, it's not available. It's out of stock, it's been out of stock for weeks, and there's no projected date when it will be in stock. So let's talk about the cylindrical bearing next. Your ball bearing has an outer race like this and an inner race like this. And then there are balls in here that roll as the whole thing turns. Cylindrical bearings work much the same way, but instead of those things being balls, they're cylinders, like this. And if you look this, it's a terrible design. If you look this up, you'll see what I mean. Each one of these cylinders obviously has a lot more surface area in contact, so it's stronger, but there's a caveat. So say this is my bearing. There are two types of loads on this bearing. There are the types of loads that are radial, in other words, in the direction of the radius. These go out like this on the bearing. However, there are also typically loads on the bearing that are axial. These loads go front to back like this along the axis of the bearing. Cylindrical bearings are very good at handling radial loads, but not nearly as good as at handling axial loads. For this reason, it makes me kind of nervous. if you reduce the axial load capacity of a bearing, and these do have reduced axial load capacity, so there is some axial load capacity because they do certain things with them and all of that, but it's still reduced. And if you reduce that capacity to handle axial loads, what might be the unintended consequences of that? It makes me nervous. I don't really know the answer to it. It might be fine, but the fact that they're going that far away from the original version, which worked pretty well, makes me nervous. The other problem with this is the direct oil feed really isn't that great. You're tapping into the oil pump and weakening that oil pump by switching out the shaft, and it's just a little bit dicey. So for those reasons, I didn't want to get into cylindrical ball bearings. Cross that one out. What about the Ellen Engineering one? Well, I love the ceramic hybrid, so that was great. And I love the fact that they've made both single and dual row bearings. But they didn't put seals on it, and they didn't provide a direct oil feed. And I think that you have to have one or the other to make sure that it's properly lubricated. In other words, this bearing is really just relying on splash lubrication, and I suspect that's not enough. Certainly Porsche didn't think that was enough because they sealed the bearing to hold oil into the bearing and didn't rely on splash lubrication. So the big problem with the Ellen Engineering bearing in my mind is that it just doesn't provide for adequate lubrication. It needs a direct oil feed or it needs seals. The other big problem with the Ellen Engineering bearing or kit or solution is price. $800 for a single bearing on an engine. That might make sense if your engine is brand new and it's worth $10,000 or $15,000 or something in that neighborhood. My engine, however, has 97,000 miles on it. And I looked, and I can buy a used engine with 100,000 miles on it, or fewer miles, for $3,000 to $4,000. So by the time I get this Ellen Engineering kit in on, I'm gonna be paying close to $1,000 probably, especially if I buy their tool kit. And that's a third to a fourth the cost of a used engine. But instead of making my engine bulletproof, I'm really just solving one of the potential problems. And if you have an engine that has 100,000 miles on it, there are a lot of things that could go wrong with it. So the reality is this kit could be fine, and this could be a bulletproof solution, even though Ellen Engineering says replace it every 50,000 miles or so. Could be great, but spending $800 on an engine that old really doesn't make that much sense. I'd much rather save my money, and if something goes wrong, I can put it toward a used engine or an engine rebuild or something like that. So at the end of the day, the lack of lubrication and the cost caused me to eliminate this one. So what was my choice? Well, should be pretty obvious. None of them. Pedro's direct oil feed system was good. I like the oil feed system. I think it's probably the best of the options. It would definitely come down to Pelican Parts or Pedro's for me. And since Pelican Parts doesn't provide a dual row bearing, would probably be Pedro's, except for the fact that it is also $800. And like I was explaining with Ellen Engineering, that's just ridiculously overpriced. It really kind of makes me angry that these people are charging so much for these solutions. They're extremely and extravagantly overpriced in my estimation. And that's backed up with my experience with the Ellen Engineering toolkit, which I was able to make for $25 and they were selling for 300 something. Now I realize that people like Allen Engineering and Pedro do a lot of work on Porsches, and they've done a lot of great work and they've contributed to the community, and I'm all for supporting them. And trust me, I get it. We should support these people. I mean, I try to contribute to the Porsche community, and the ads in front of the videos support me. The difference is, the ads in front of my videos are enough to buy me coffee. Maybe. The markup on these kits is enough to bankrupt small third world countries. So, yeah, I am fine supporting people who contribute to the community, but it makes me angry when people mark things up by like 1,000% in the case of the toolkit. And even in these more expensive kits, I'm sure their cost is higher, but $800 is prohibitive. So yeah, I decided not to use any of the kits out there. What I did instead is I tried to source a ball bearing that was really similar to the original Porsche part, with just one exception, and that it is a hybrid ceramic ball bearing, because hybrid ceramic ball bearings are superior in every way, and they don't really have any disadvantage over regular steel ball bearings. So what I did is I sourced a hybrid ceramic ball bearing, and I sourced one that has two seals on it, like the original part. And I think that this will be very similar to the original factory part, but the fact that it is a ceramic ball bearing will extend its life and make it a little bit more robust. The good news also was that my solution was probably about 200 bucks, maybe a little less than 200 bucks. So it was really affordable, and that seems like a reasonable amount to pay to fix a single problem in an engine that's worth $3,000 or $4,000. So yeah, I'm spending about $200, hybrid ceramic bearing, few custom parts that I'm making, and that's what I'm going to be putting into my Boxster. Anyway, thanks for watching. I totally appreciate it. I hope you found this useful and informative. There are definitely a lot of good options, and several of these options have been proven to be reliable. So my gripes with them, you gotta take it with a grain of salt. They're still good options. I just chose not to go with them for the reasons that I went with. So if you went with one of these options, it's okay. Still love you. Thanks for watching. I will see you next time.